Academic Integrity Matters, Part 5, Scenarios.
We'll be going over three different scenarios, and with each scenario, we'll discuss what the academic misconduct was and some of the possible consequences. So to start off, Bob finds the perfect sentence to fit into his essay, but he wants to be original. And so he copies down the sentence in his own words for his essay without citing. What is Bob guilty of? Well, Bob is guilty of plagiarism, and this is because he doesn't provide a citation for the sentence that he took. And what kinds of consequences might Bob face? Well, for something like this, because it is only a single sentence, and if it were Bob's first time performing plagiarism, then he would likely get some form of a written reprimand and possibly a referral to the Academic Integrity Mentorships Workshop. And if the professor found that Bob had done this more than once on the same essay, he may also get a score of 0. So, what if Bob's sister is having trouble finishing a math worksheet? And because he's already taken the class before, he gives her the worksheet. What is Bob guilty of? Well, in this case, Bob is guilty of aiding and abetting. And the reason for this is that he merely gives the answers to his sister instead of having her do the questions herself and understand the material. And so even though Bob isn't currently in this class, it is possible for the professor to do a retroactive grade reduction because of this instance, and depending on how much that worksheet was worth for his sister. And so because of this, he also actually hurts his sister because she's not learning the material that she needs for the exam that will be coming up. And the last scenario. During a class, the professor leaves the room, and while the professor is gone, Bob takes a photo of the final exam. Then he starts to sell the photos. What is Bob guilty of? Well, to start off, he's of course guilty of improper access to exam materials because he took a picture of the exam before it was given out. He's also guilty of aiding and abetting because he's helping other students to cheat by selling these photos. Furthermore, Bob is guilty of cheating himself because he'll be using these photos on the upcoming exam. And lastly, this can be viewed as a form of obstruction because he's making it harder for the students that aren't cheating to gain a good grade if the professor marks on a curve. So what form of consequences might Bob face here? Well, he could face anything from a 0 on the exam, a 0 in the grade, or possibly even expulsion from the university. And this is mainly because Bob is not only hurting himself, he's hurting the entire class.
Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions about academic integrity at the university, the Academic Success Center is there to help you. Contact us through email or drop in anytime at the Abbotsford or Chilliwack Academic Success Centers. Any questions for the tutors or academic integrity mentors are always kept confidential. Earn your grades the honest way.